Another edition of Riding Home, this time actually in a car. So we got a chance to listen to Kirby today. Well, the biggest thing, of course, was the Stetson stuff. I mean, I guess we have to talk about it because it continues to be discussed.
Yeah, Stetson is the guy. Kirby told us again today. We heard Todd Monken talk about it yesterday. And they both said he gives us the best chance to win. And the biggest reason for that, I think we can all tell, is his mobility. He's made plays with his feet a lot this year. And Todd Monken was basically, you know, just gushing over him yesterday. And Kirby did the same thing today. They know that they can win a national championship. They believe they can win a national championship with Stetson Bennett. He's going to have to play better than he did against Alabama. I really think he can beat Michigan. That's a really tough defense. And he might struggle, you know, here and there because they're stout. They're going to be coming after him. But that makes it all the more reason for a mobile quarterback to be in there when you have Aiden Hutchinson and those guys coming after you left and right, having a guy who can create with his feet, get the ball out of his hands quickly when he needs to, possibly throw the ball deep when they've got, you know, an opportunity for it. But overall, I mean, we heard from Jamari, we heard from Trayvon, and they said all the right things as well. But of course, this is all about the quarterbacks. JT Daniels is in Miami. Maybe he gets a series or two in the game. But right now, this is Stetson's team, and they've made that very, very clear both, you know, throughout the week.
I want to throw it to the back seat, but you mentioned the running. I want to see Stetson run more effectively. That was really a weapon, and it kind of slowed down as the season went on.
Yeah, that's not something that they really did against Alabama.
No.
I mean, I don't know. He probably had negative net rushing yards because of the sacks, but he didn't really roll out as much. We talked about that last night. They didn't use the play action rollout against Alabama the way that they did it against other teams. He wasn't a threat on the ground against Alabama, and that was one of the reasons why they struggled on offense for a better part of the game. But the conversation does continue, 95. even if it shouldn't. That's but where we're at is people don't want to stop chirping about who the quarterback is, and that stretches from media members to fans to.
But this group is kind of like, hey, it's what it is.
Yeah, no. Stetson is the starter. That is what has been confirmed all week. It's what we've assumed for the last month, and that's what it is. If you support it or don't, Stetson's starting. And if you're a fan, you got to root for him to play well and stop rooting for him to
fail,
to struggle in the first half just to put JT in. Why would you want to risk a bad half?
Dylan, there's no certainty that JT comes and lights it up.
Well,
there's
people,
no certainty.
People just want to be right, and that's why they hope for
yes.
that. I mean, and I get that. That's just human nature. But at the same time, at a point, you just got to live with it, and that people won't. And I'm honestly tired of hearing about it and talking about it, but we do have to because it's discussed at every press conference. And I did think it was interesting. That's the most definite Kirby has ever been, I feel like, about a quarterback. And in a situation where it's a little less, you know, cemented than past quarterback situations. But that was the first time I've ever really heard him say, like, this guy is our starter.
If they were both five-star quarterbacks, would this be an issue? Or is it because if Stetson Bennett is the walk-on beating out the five-star who started the season, and now, because his numbers aren't bad. Stetson Bennett has proved that he can beat anyone he's played against except Alabama so far, and there's a good chance that he might get another opportunity. But he has played well against top 10 Arkansas, top 10 Kentucky, Florida when it mattered most. He
Auburn
didn't play his best. Auburn, he played tremendous, and that's a strong, stout Auburn defense that he went up against. So the story is crazy. You got, you know, the Pierce County former walk-on transferring away, transferring back. It is a great story, but when you have a guy, five-star quarterback from California, who was this all-world, at a modern day, I mean, the story builds, you know, itself, really. So I understand why people want to continue to talk about this, because obviously their quarterbacks is the most, you know, important position on the team. And the coaches got multiple questions about the quarterbacks, and I thought they said everything that everyone in this car has been talking about. Stetson gives them the best opportunity to win, and a lot of that is due to his feet, and they confirmed that this week.
Well, it does, like, you know, when you're throwing the ball, yeah, it does come out quick with JT. There's a lot to be said for JT, and Kirby talked about that today, is every time we just start talking about this, it feels like, you know, he kind of made it seem like whenever we do this, it feels like I got a pick and I'm putting JT down. That's my words. I'm putting words into Kirby's mouth. But, I mean, at the end of the day, just boiling down to things, yeah, the story is, either story would be awesome. I mean, JT coming back from injury and mental health stuff and transferring from SC. But, like, man, listen, they're not goofing around here. They're doing this for a reason. This is not a conspiracy. They want to win. They need to win. It's time. And they feel that Stetson Gibson the best chance to win. I think I've said to Matt in the past, Stetson's, I've said privately to Matt, I would not, I think Stetson's the better quarterback right now. I don't know, I felt I was going into my attic. I remember saying that. And then, of course, soon thereafter, he really did not play well against Alabama, and I felt kind of dumb. But guys don't play well at times. And, you know, did JT really play great against Clemson?
He did against South Carolina, but yeah, against Clemson, he had the side issue.
His durability is an issue too, Ryan. I mean, you got to play. You got to be available to play. Could you imagine if JT were the starter and he were not in Miami day one? People would be flipping out. We're talking about Georgia fans here.
He has a durability issue.
Kirby even said today if he's healthy. I'm like, what? Healthy from COVID? Or
I don't know, but he's dealt with the lat, he's dealt with the oblique, he's dealt with the knee that lingered into his tenure in Georgia. You know, COVID's kind of another conversation, but he hasn't been reliable to be on the field, and that's why we're in this position now, and that's why all these conversations have been happening, because of JT's durability issues. It's why that you guys like to come and call him Bubble Boy, which cracked me up a couple weeks ago.
No, now that is from what other people were saying.
Not you guys. I'm talking.
Oh, about yeah, that. Yeah. I was going to say. I got you. Like, wait, what?
No, not you guys. But that's why we're in this situation right now, where Stetson's played all year long, and he 18. Played well enough to earn the job, and that's where we're at. But we don't know what's going to happen next
season. I'm going to have to really make this work.
That was my bad.
Let's make it work?
Let's go, Dean.
I think we can make it work. This guy's got to make a decision. Boom. I've got it.
Great driving,
don't hit
man.
Me in the back.
There we go.
You know, yes, that's on me. Oldsmobile.
That was on me.
I got you. But hey, we're going where we're going. Just like the traffic, there are times. No, look at this guy. Aggressive.
We didn't do that.
Oh, that's a plan, though.
Don't let him in. It's almost
good. Dylan, you got it. You got to be ready. I mean, JT's got to be ready, too. This is not exclusively that Stetson's going to be there no matter what. Man, he could have a hammy. You know, who knows?
He did mention that Stetson is reliable. And Stetson has been a reliable quarterback. Again, yeah, you don't play your best game every single time, especially against the best teams in the country.
The defense is going to have to play better. I mean,
oh yeah,
that was the bulk of the last game.
They got to get more pressure. And Michigan's offensive line is stout. It is a very strong unit. They're going to run the ball as much as they can. But didn't mean to cut you off, Dylan. But yeah, the defense is going to have to play better and get more pressure on Cade McNamara, who is, you know, is he that much better than Stetson Bennett?
No, I think
quarterbacks are definitely even in this game.
I think Stetson's better.
They need to send pressure. I mean, I felt like they only sent a few guys against Alabama. They weren't, you know, sending as many blitzes as I thought they should have. They thought they could get more pressure with just their defensive line, and it just wasn't working. And
Alabama's got a really good line, too.
That made no sense to me, though, because we saw the week before Auburn have so much success bringing 5 and 6 for the majority of the game, and Georgia just went away from that.
But I hate to be this way. Can't coaches just make mistakes and they're wrong and then they can correct them? I mean, like, we make mistakes all the time in life.
Yeah, but the problem is it wasn't really corrected in the game.
No, not in the game, but, you know, that was not a do-or-die game for them. And
it wasn't.
And that's the wrong way to look at it. But
you could see that clearly, though. Alabama came out with more fire because it was a must-win for them. And Georgia lost, and they're still number 3. They kind of knew that going into the game. This is a must-win.
Yeah.
There needs to be coaching adjustments in the game if something's not working, figure it out.
I think this game's going to be very similar to the Clemson game.
Yeah.
I saw the Clemson game last night, saw how much of a fight that was. I think I expect Michigan to have more success than Clemson in terms of offensively, but I think it's going to be similar to that. And I wonder, now I wouldn't change anything, but would Stetson have been better for Georgia in the Clemson game? Probably not.
If they prepared him.
But that interception from JT was pretty bad.
Do you think Michigan rushes for 120 yards?
I don't think that's out of the question.
I think they get that number. I don't know. We've seen teams run for over 120, 150 yards.
Not a lot.
Three times? Is that how many times?
Yeah, out of 13 games.
It doesn't mean that Georgia's going to lose the game, though. Yeah. But Michigan runs the ball so much and they run so well, I think it's realistic that they get that number. It's a matter of if they use that to get explosive plays over the top. That's what Georgia has to prevent, and that's more of my concern.
Well, it's going to be a turnovers game. You can say that with every game, but I think in this game where that could be low scoring, turnovers, especially in the second half, are going
to
be key.
James and Zamir better be ready to go. I mean, no matter who the quarterback is, James and Zamir better be ready because this is going to be a fight the whole day.
Is Kenny healthy? Is Kenny?
From what I can tell, I mean, Kendall Milton's healthy. Good. I don't know about Kendall.
I think Kendall's as healthy as he's been, though.
And they certainly, I mean, I wouldn't want Kendall Milton closing the game out if I were Michigan. And a fully healthy Kendall Milton is not a lot of fun.
Yeah, he can put it on the ground, though.
Well, he did against Kentucky, right? What happened with the Auburn game? Was that the one they hammered? They've used Kendall to close it out. Yeah. And like, you could see in the Clemson game, like, Georgia should have won that game 20-3. And they left opportunities out there in the red zone and this and that. I mean, like, you got to score touchdowns. That's one thing Dylan and I were talking about yesterday is they're going to have to score touchdowns.
For who?
Georgia.
Georgia? Yeah. I mean, and that was an issue against – and that's why hopefully it's not like the Clemson game because their offense is going to need to score.
Yeah.
You know, if they can get a defensive touchdown, then that helps significantly. But you can't rely on that.
They had a few early in the season. Haven't had one in – a hot minute since.
Now, Georgia's got to play the way they have the bulk of the year. And if they do that, this discussion of Stetson, like, if the focus is Stetson, you're in trouble. If the focus is McNamara, you're in trouble. They don't want to play that style, Georgia. They want to play the way they want to play. And they're going to have to figure out how to do that. Easier said than done.
If Michigan throws the ball 40 times, they're going to lose. If Stetson Bennett throws the ball 40 times, he's Georgia's.
They have
lose.
Not won with Stetson throwing it, I think, over 30, but definitely not 40. Yeah. And most teams don't succeed that way. It's just what it is. I don't know. I mean, Ryan, as we wrap up.
Look, if Stetson Bennett gets this job done the next two games, the apologies better be as loud as all the hate was. But it won't be.
That won't happen.
And they need to run the ball well. They need to get all four of those guys involved, in my opinion. But Zamir,
that was an issue
against Alabama is they – they freaked out when they got down by double digits, and they completely abandoned that. But they were running well against them.
But look, y'all,
that can't happen again.
We see things the way we see it, very close. But 40,000 view, Las Vegas thinks Georgia is the better team. They still think they're better than Alabama. If they didn't think that, the line wouldn't be that Georgia's the favorite. So, I just think, as the Beastie Boys would say, got to get it together and do the job. All right, we'll see you on the next edition of Riding Home. Thanks for watching. We'll see you over on the website.